Hey, you, all you lovely people out there, it's your main man, Andrew, speaking, and this is going to be a short video. A very short one, and I have some dire news I need to explain to my fellow subscribers, followers, and friends, and all of the above. Your main man Andrew is going to be taking a break from the PlayStation. I mean by PlayStation, I mean the PS4. So I might be off the PlayStation for maybe a couple days, or a couple weeks, or a year, depending on what my mood is. So this is a dire need. Let me make sure I'm not going to be gone for a year. That's just an understatement. It could be a month, or it could be a couple of weeks. Just taking a break, or it could be a couple of days, depending on what mood I'm in. Let me just jump to the chase. I enjoy being in this queue, and I enjoy all of the support, and I thank you subscribers and close friends of mine for supporting me for this long. I have over 30 subscribers, or well over that, and I really appreciate all the support and all the kindness that you guys have been supporting me for this long. Really appreciate it, and I thank every last one of you for that. As that has been said, I haven't gotten this far in the YouTube videos without subscribers and followers and my friends. So I really appreciate that. It means the world to me when you guys support my channel like that. Now, my very reason why I'm going to be off for a couple of days or a couple of weeks is because I need a break from Xenoverse 2 and any PlayStation related thing that happened on the PS4. I've been stressed enough dealing with players who are, let's just say, rude to me and are so basically, the word would be cancerous, as most people would call it, because they trash talk and so forth, just for how they react. And for example, if I really went on rank, I'm just gonna be using a Nas name right now. I don't know what this person is actually like, but my account with him was not pleasant. I'll account him a couple times on online battles and ranked for Xenoverse that he really got to me. Well, there's still people that got to me, but I'm just pointing out this one particular person got to me. I don't know if I know his gamer tag is name, or his PSN name is Online Strike or something like that. If I butchered that name, I'm sorry, but right now I just know that you were a jerk to me the other day, and I don't know the real reason why you said some meaningful things to him, but for the record, I was only doing rank because I needed that outfit that they had for the whole ranking system for Tapion's clothes. Usually I don't do PvP because of how cancerous people can get on it. I mean, all the trash talking and shit. Pardon my language, I'm not trying to swear, but they really do swear a lot when it comes to these matches. I mean, I get the internet is, I get the quality of the this internet service on Xenoverse 2 is not good, and I lose some of my dials that way, but there's really no need for the name calling. There's really no need. At this point, I would just say that's immature of anyone who does shit like that. I mean, I don't usually... to be honest, I do play cheap, but that's because some people on in rank play cheap. Like, for example, if they're using a male Earthling the whole time, and most of them do use male Earthlings, in rank, they'll use an unfinishable combo and then break your stamina, and then they do an infinite combo and then finish you off like that. Me, I think that's literally cheating. That's so the cheat that they're cheating to the point where it's annoying. And the whole perfect blocking spamming thing is really annoying too. And the keystone. Those are the only assets of this game except for the hit detection with certain characters on our CACs, like for example, like the female Majin, that one combo that puts you up in the air and then they use a stamina break, that's an unusual combo. And it's the same like Trunks when he grabs you and then teleports on the top and then your stamina break you automatically like that. And same with Gogeta. This is more like a combo that you do automatically. Button presses where he does the two kicks and then stamina breaks you in the middle. It's stuff like that that makes me a little annoyed, and then they call themselves good at this game just because they use cheap shit like that. Now I will say that I do have a couple of cheap presets on my Saiyan, on my other CACs that I made and so forth. The most cheap shit that I've seen is modders. I've seen people using mods online, and I really say that's not okay. That's the most cheap thing of it all, and then they say it's okay because they say, oh, well, everybody's using mods these days. But seriously, if you use mods online, then the other shit that I said from earlier is nothing compared to what. To what I just said, that if you use mods and you're saying that you're good, you're trash. I hate to say it, but you're trash. More or less, more trash than someone who fucking plays bad in the game. And if you don't want my word to put it, you can argue with so many people that dealt with you. That's the most hated thing I really hate about this game. I mean, if you do want mods and you don't fucking cheat online thing, go for it. I mean, I do consider fucking them if they're using mods and extra missions and Hello Quest. That's cheap too. I don't care how you put it, if you do shit like that, it's not cool. Save it for the PC or something. I mean, if they do mods on the Xbox, that's not my thing. I could care less. Well, I do would care a lot, but I don't have Xbox. But my point is, if you're using mods, you know, fucking give people problems with it, especially online if you're doing a cheater. Now, I'm not trying to defend mods, I'm just literally just saying. Because some people actually like it, and I don't want to get the wrong idea. I'm just trying to hate on mods. Now, if that's said and done, I just wanted to let my viewers know that I might be off for a week. Depending on on the situation right now is just, I did a raid, I'm done with the game for right now. I just need a break because I cannot deal with the cancer shit that people have been talking to me. I don't even like doing rank. Because honestly, there's literally just shows off and tries to be number one in the game and go right ahead. But most people literally don't care about that. At least that's what I see it. You know, I'm like one of those people who say, I don't care. I mean, I get why they reset the TP, but I don't understand why they don't reset the BP. I don't know what the hell the reason why. And that goes to another thing that some people are fucking boosting. For example, let me bring up the leaderboard. I'm going to the right match. You see the guy that's in first place and some of the people that are next to him. That's one of the reasons why I don't care much for it. Because these three people right here, right down the line, and I have a real problem with this one and this one. Oh, pulling out that one. This one in particular. This one fucking used me for being a douchebag. I will say that this guy is a complete jerk, and he has a new channel. I wish I could have the boys. Nonetheless, this guy, this one, and this one. I don't know about the rest of them, but I do know their boost. I was once friends with this one, is because how I know he's boosting is because he said one time he's only doing it to make sure other YouTubers don't get up in first place. And he said, oh, I don't care much for the BP. Well, if you don't care much for it, why are you in first place? You don't even hardly play the game at all. So why do you even care that you're in first place? I certainly don't give a damn if you're in first place, but you don't deserve to be in first place if all you're doing is not playing the damn game at all, and fucking cheat at it. If you want to tell me off about that, then go right ahead. A lot of people already get it online anyways on YouTube. You won't be any different. That's another reason why I have a problem with this game, but I'm not trying to hate on it. I love the universe. But they really need to fix this problem with the boosters and the mods and shit. And some of the other crap. If they can fix it in Universe 3, then I will be down for that game. And I don't know about the rest of the ones who are high like this. I'm not gonna hate on them because actually they don't even know my friends. I'm just saying, some of these guys here are probably boosting or somewhat trying. For me personally, I don't like him. I don't like him because this one right here is a modder. He uses mods and he's a hacker. So he needs to be removed. Let's see. Basically, the people that I'm stopping on their names are the ones I really dislike. I actually have good times with some people that do actually play good at the game. Some play cheap, but I still play with them anyways and still have a good time. others, I just don't get along with for, I don't know what reason. This is one guy, I don't know what this dude's problem was. One of my friends told me that I insulted him, and I don't understand why he said I insulted him, or teased him, or whatever, but I don't remember teasing him. So he has issues. I mean, I could go right down this list and tell you I ran into some of the highest players in the universe. I don't know what's up with, Fake Camper. I don't know what his deal is. For some reason, you know, that's a bad one. Now, here's a guy that really has issues. He's Super Itachi. I never faced a guy in my perspective, but I've seen a lot of YouTubers complain about him lately. So he's an issue. Well, you get the gist of what I'm trying to say. Even, you know, myself included, I have enemies and it's fucking like people. There's one more person I need to show you guys that, frankly, I have problems with. Give me a heads up if you wanna say hi or something before friending me. Cause I do get random friend requests, and sometimes I don't accept them if I don't know the person, and if I don't know what they're gonna do, then I'm a little iffy. I have good intentions why I do shit like that. Please don't take it at heartbreak that if I delete your friend request, it's not because I hate you, it's probably just because I don't know you, or it could be something else. So yeah. But if you're on my block list and you were a jerk to me, then I'm not accepting your friend request. Maybe if you give me an apology or something. But I'm not gonna sit here and demand a fucking apology. I'm not gonna do that. Some people don't get along with others. Typically me, I don't get along with some people. That's just some people. Well, I don't think I can find this. If I try this section in the workshop. Well, these have got to be all brand new on TK marks since that reset already. Excuse me. I'm gonna take a look at the raid. Well, congratulate on people who made it first place and all of that jazz. To be expected, they used female Earthlings and Saiyans in a Freezer race, that will definitely get the points up like that. Oh, look at that, I made it for 14th place. Hallelujah. Made it up with some of my friends. That was a good raid. I enjoyed it. I never participated in the first baby grade 8 raid that they had for the game. I really wish they brought back the alpha for that so I could get my hands on it. But other than that, this was definitely worth a raid to do it. Especially with the event going on for the Tapion clothes, that really helped out. I really needed the TP medals to get a certain figure that is so annoying that it's so hard to get. And at this point, I really want to spend new money in the PlayStation Store just to get 5,000 TP medals, but I'm not going to do that. Because then I would be paying to win for to get that certain figure, and I'm not going to do that. But you wouldn't blame me for the figure that I want to get is really OP. And I think I spent over 15,000 TP metal just trying to get it, and I still didn't get it. Some people get lucky by getting it, and I'm just not one of those lucky people. Well, I can't find the dude, but just beware of a guy named All Might Strikes or something like that. All Might Strike or something like that. He is really not a nice dude. If someone defends him, then go always go right ahead. But when I close account with the dude, I don't like him. I don't like people who trash talk. That's one of the reasons why I'm taking a break from this game. That and GTA and stuff like that. There's just literally no. Some people online are more disrespectful than the ones I encounter in real life. For some reasons, I don't know why. And sometimes it's the opposite. Sometimes I meet some people who are worse public than they are online. The moral of the story is sometimes you can't judge a profile's color. Well, I'm gonna show off some of the items that I got for the raid and the events that I did throughout the weeks. So at least I'm gonna show you something before I actually get off. And I also got a couple new games that I want to try out. One of them I might live stream one of these days because it's kind of related to one of my childhood games that I played when I was young. So I hope you really are looking forward to that. And I might do a live stream for Freedom Planet. So check that bell and check my videos if you want to see more content in the future. I don't do videos every day because I need breaks now and then, but I will show off some of the clothes. Here's some of Tapion's clothes that you can get from the Human Link. Personally, when I look at this outfit, it looks okay, it looks decent. But if you look at the actual wig, then you're gonna have a change of heart. Just trust me on this, folks. You know what I'm talking about. I mean, the clothes themselves reminds me of Link from Legend of Zelda. The because basically Tapion is almost the identical as far as Link. Let's just say Tapion is the Link of Dragon Ball in some people's eyes. You got the Ocarina, you got the clothes, you got the sword. Almost identical. And that's why I'm saying almost. Now there is one other outfit that I didn't get in the past. I also gotten the Golden Grade 8 suit, and I think most people have it by now, but it's really hard to get. So I got that, I got the Golden Scouter, I got the Golden Gi, I got the Golden Turtle Shell. So I'm basically up Golden amount. It doesn't look half bad. The stats, actually, it's better than, the Golden Gi, in my opinion. For example, if you go to the Golden Gi, or the Golden Turtle, Hermit Gi, or whatever you want to call it, the stats are fucking awful. For Stamer and Ki Blast, the strike on it is fucking insane. So I say, retrospects, the Golden Grade 8 key is the Golden Grade 8 key that you want, or the Golden key that you want. Why? We need to stop calling it key, it's just Golden Grade 8 suit. But nonetheless, the outfit looks awesome. Alright, enough with that. I'm gonna show off some of the accessories. Now, feel warning. The accessories, to my opinion, are the ugliest shit that I ever seen on the CDC. And that's my opinion. If you like it, congratulations on loving it. Okay, let me see. I think I'll show off the Golden Scouter if I can find it. I already passed it, but that's the Golden Grade 8 head and tail. It looks kind of fine, I guess. Okay, here's the Golden Scouter. The only difference is this is golden instead of just the plain leather powder. Okay, here comes one of the, here's two of the outfits I got from the event. The Tapion wig I got from the event for Link. That's what it looks like. To be honest, I think the outfit or the hair for the CDCs for that is better looking than this shit. I don't know why, it just makes my character look ugly. To be honest, it really does. And I don't mind it, but I just can't fucking imagine me looking like that when I'm fighting. Now, here's the second variation of Hercules wig, and that's what I got for the raid, besides the Golden Grade 8 suit. Now, this is the variation for the GT Saga, and I think that was a wonderful idea of the way they're considering this for the characters. But, like I said before, it just does not look right. And I could put this on some other characters of mine, and look fine, but on my Saiyan, look at that. That just does not look right to me. I want to hear your thoughts and opinions about this. I mean, if you like it, feel free to use it for your character, but it just does not look like it. Here's this. I think I'd rather have the Tapion wig. I do like the Afro go on it, though. That doesn't look that bad. The whole ball thing? I don't Maybe I'm just looking way too much into this, but nonetheless, that's my thing. Anyway. And by the way, I don't judge people by their looks. I judge them by their attitude and shit like that. But other words, this just holograms. See, that's what his hair is supposed to be like. Not bald. Now, you know, outfits are just, I gotta check. That's the other variation for Hercule. The first variation that you just begin. I need to check if I got the golden helmet on the shell. See, that's what the regular shell looks like. Should have had the golden one too. So that was a bonus. Why I will go with the golden key that you got. So if you want to look for accessories for that, you can match with that. Alright, and that was for a bonus, so that was like basically available to anyone to use. But a member of the Pride Troopers! I also got, Mal Cooler's head. Still need to get Mega Freeze's head too, but I'll save that for later. Look at that. Outfits like that are fun. I guess it's to see how you look at it, I guess. Now, if I pronounce this right or something, I'll try. Top mustache. Anyway, I'd say this looks weird, but at the same time, it looks funny. Alright, what was that? Oh, yes. So, I'm gonna be off for a couple of days. I'll probably be playing my Switch or something, playing Super Mario Party, because I just got that game. Either way, I don't know what my opinion about it, about the game yet, but I did see some videos about it. It looks good so far, so I'm really looking forward to it, since it's going back to the home game style of input that the original Mario Party's had, not the whole train and vehicle or whatever. Some of the mini games are questionable, but I'll have to learn from the experience and see how it works. I might be doing a YouTube video about it, but because I don't have that property under other systems, because they don't support that chip. Why? But I will give you my thoughts and opinions about the game once I come back to the PlayStation. I'm gonna leave some of my friends in charge of my communities while I'm gone. They'll keep an eye on things and see if anything goes wrong or right? So, people that I'm gonna be leaving in charge for my communities and basically anything that has to do with my account is gonna be under these, my closest friends on the PS4, Toby Dogs Games, Silver Drift, GH96 Gamer, Power Ranger, and Riley Pokemon. Those are the people that are in charge. Some of them are the moderators in my community. And some of my other friends will keep an eye on things too when I'm gone. And while I'm actually editing one of them reasons. So they'll keep me notified on what's going on and stuff like that. And to keep an eye on things. Anything goes wrong while I'm off my PlayStation, and if anybody thinks twice is trying to mess with my games while I'm gone, then they're gonna have a really very angry person on their hands, and it might even be a problem for them. But I'm not gonna say to the point where it's gonna have their account created. I will say that something like that goes on while I'm not on the way, then I will have to bring it up to places. Because I'm not going to tolerate that happening again, since one of my communities was attacked for no reason from two people. I'm not going to give out their names, but I will say this, they're never going to do it to me again, because they don't have that power. Yeah, my friends will keep an eye on things when I'm gone. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you disliked it and give it a thumbs down, feel free to. Everybody has their opinions on what they like and dislike, so I'll catch you later in the next video, probably in a week or so, if I get back on. So take care. Hope to see you guys real soon, and I'll have a great time. Have a nice day. Bye.